Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika, and in this video we're going to compare ShapeBuilder tools in Illustrator and the new one in Affinity Designer, and we'll take a look at ShapeBuilding methods in general. So let's first take a look at what the ShapeBuilder tool is. Now, if you have multiple shapes like these two, you can take the ShapeBuilder tool and then you can move the tool over them, and you can also click and drag and make combinations of shapes and use those shapes. So this resulted in these two shapes. The Shape Builder tool in Illustrator can be configured by double clicking it, and you see there are a lot of options you can set up. So I'm going to cancel that. It doesn't only work with closed, but also with open paths like these. So I can move in here and I could click here and make this one a shape, or press the Alt key and click here and delete those, and they stay open paths like so. So there's this paths, and I have taken off some part of it. It also has a gap detection. Now, of course, you should draw clean shapes, but sometimes it's not possible. There are hand-drawn elements, or you have shapes like cartoons that you want to fill with color, and then you have gaps in it, like in here. And then you can set up the gap detection. And Illustrator could still make this shape here, so like so. Of course, this also works with more complicated shapes like these Celtic rings. And I'm going to delete this inner one and just use these. And then you can again go to the ShapeBuilder tool and you can start with deleting the parts like so. And then you get as a result these rings. And of course, once you have deleted the parts you want to get rid of, then you can start combining the parts you want to keep. And I need to draw more precise, like so, and then these get combined. That's nice. Now let's take a look at how Affinity Designer's shape building works. I've got the two shapes and the tool is down here. You need to set up the options over there in this control bar, and you need to set up how the tool works. So you need to set up whether it adds or subtracts a shape. So in order to do that, you set that up and then drag over it. You can also set up nothing and then first click on something and later decide what you want to do with it. But you have to travel up from down your shape to this bar. And you can also use it on open paths, these, and then again choose the method and then delete. And also, if you want to create a shape, first set up that add function. When you want to work with gaps, like in this shape, and use the shape builder, then you see it won't recognize that there is a gap and it won't close it automatically. If you have this kind of Celtic ring design, so let's select this here and I'm going to delete this, and then let's select it again. And also, again, you can first delete what you want to delete by just clicking on it, and then you can later combine these. Let's first go to the creation, like so, and then it will connect them, like so. And again, you have to draw precisely just like in Illustrator, like so. The downside of both shape building tools is they consume your original objects. In Affinity Designer, when you use the Shapebuilder tool, you can press this button and keep your original objects, but they are just the original objects. You can't have both. Let's go back to Illustrator, because Illustrator can take care of that for you. Now, in order to show that, I have a slightly more difficult shape like this, and below the Shapebuilder tool, you've got the Live Paint bucket. And the Live Paint bucket also has options. Double click it, and then you have the options. And to start this, you select a color in those squares, and then you can just click on it and fill it in. It is now a Live Paint object. And now you can paint. With the Alt key, pick up a color and then paint whatever you need to paint. I need to be more precise there. So let's do that again. And you see this has been painted. And again, I can go with those shapes. And let's do something else and combine these here. And then combine these, and you see I can also use this and fill this. Now, what's the difference to the shape building? The difference is that the original shapes are still there. You can double click this, and there you see is a circle. And this circle can be edited. So you can edit it, and you see that gap up there adjusts. Also, when I select this shape here, then you see that fill adapts. So you have the final drawing and you still have the original shapes. So you see, the Shape Builder tool is a much needed addition to Affinity Designer's functionality, but can't quite keep up with Illustrator's way of combining objects. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time!